All right, so there's the motor homunculus. So now what I want to tell you about that is you just think about what this thing is like. It's taking the world apart and it's talking about it. So that's what a human being is like. And that, to me, that's kind of an image of the mythological hero. It's the thing that can speak magic words and take the world apart. Now, in one of the stories I'm going to tell you today, which is the story of the Enuma Elish, which is the oldest written story that we have, it's a Mesopotamian story, and it's from the same pool of stories that the creation account in Genesis was extracted. It isn't obvious what the temporal sequence was, but imagine there was a pool of stories in the Middle East that were of indefinite age, tens of thousands of years, and each of them were developed in a slightly different way, although the themes underneath were similar. There are great parallels between the Mesopotamian creation account and the first part of the creation account in Genesis. So it was discovered in the late 1900s, and Isis just destroyed a huge treasure trove of that sort of manuscripts. So just so you know, so at Nineveh, so we can thank the war in the Middle East for the destruction of a huge treasure house of irreplaceable human knowledge. And a lot of that's happening very, very frequently. It's an absolute bloody disgraceful catastrophe. So anyway, so you know, that's the human being. Lips, tongues, hands, and the face. Your face is also extraordinarily amenable to voluntary manipulation. So you can learn to move single neurons in the tissue underneath your eyes. That's how high resolution your face is, and that's partly because it's a broadcast screen, which is why people are always looking at it, right? And that's why if you watch a movie, it's always concentrating on people's faces, is because they're just broadcasting what? They're broadcasting their stories constantly, and we're looking at their faces. What are you looking at? What are your eyes pointing at? What are you up to? What's your emotional expression? What are you going to do next? What do you think about me? Where are you going? And you're broad, like, you find someone who has had too much plastic surgery uncanny because their face is dead, because you cannot tell what they're up to. They've got this zombie-like aspect that's terrifying. And people like that got killed. That's why we're not like that. Or they didn't mate. It's like you want to know what that other person is up to. And I told you already that's how the whites of our eyes evolved, right? Do you remember that story? Gorillas don't have that distinction between the iris and the whites, not like human beings. And our eyes are very sharp. And one thing we really want to know is, what are you looking at and why? What are you up to? And if I can tell what you're looking at, I can infer what you're going to do. And you want to broadcast that. Well, except when you don't want to broadcast it. But, you know, most of the time you want to be pretty transparent to other people, because otherwise they won't trust you. And if they don't trust you, they won't cooperate with you. They won't compete with you. And the probability that they'll come after you is extraordinarily high, because you'll be evil predator in no time flat. So...